Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create your own life mask sculpture, casting its shadow on a marble pedestal. I provided this PSD template for you to download so you can follow along. Its link is located in this video's description or project files. It includes two layers, a red curtain and a marble pedestal. Notice that because the pedestal is lit mostly from the left, we want our subject to be mostly lit from the left as well. If your subject is lit from the right, as in this example, we'll need to flip it. I'll go to Image, Image Rotation, and Flip Horizontal. If your subject is male and has sideburns, we'll remove them. I'll use the Clone Stamp tool. To make the tool bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. I've done many tutorials showing how to use this tool, so to save time, I won't be going over how to use it here. Once the sideburns are removed, the next step is to create a selection around your subject so we can cut it out from its background. There are many ways to do this, and your choice should depend on the characteristics of your photo. If your background is just one color, as in this example, use your magic wand tool to make the selection. The tolerance default value is 32, which is generally fine for one color. Make sure contiguous is checked. Contiguous only selects pixels outside your subject when you click on your background. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Press Q on your keyboard to make the selection into a quick mask. Next, we'll draw in shapes inside and around your subject, which creates the basic shape of our life mask. For this example, I'll use the Pen tool. I did an in-depth tutorial on the Pen tool, so if you'd like to watch it, I provided its link as well. We'll be filling the inside of each of the closed paths with the quick mask. To add another path, press and hold the Shift key as you click on the first anchor point of the new path. Then, release Shift and draw your new path. Use these steps to create additional paths. If you want more room on your canvas to draw the paths, zoom out by pressing Ctrl or Command plus the minus key on your keyboard. We want to make all the paths into selections. To do this, open your Paths panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Paths. Ctrl-click or Command-click the thumbnail to make selections of the paths. We'll fill the selections with the quick mask. But first, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the selections with a solid quick mask. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. To fit your document back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Open back your Layers panel and change your quick mask into a selection. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the face onto its own layer. Click the eyeball icon next to the background to hide the layer, and double-click the thumbnail of the face to open its layer style window. Click Inner Shadow. The color is black, the blend mode is linear burn, and the opacity is 30%. Uncheck Global Light, and make the angle minus 90 degrees. The distance is 2 pixels, and the size is 5 pixels. If you're using a version of Photoshop that has no plus signs next to the layer styles, I'll show you what to do in a minute. If you do see a plus sign next to Inner Shadow, click on the plus sign to open an additional Inner Shadow layer style. Click on the new Inner Shadow, and this time, pick White. The blend mode is linear dodge, and the opacity is 15%. Uncheck global light, and make the angle 90 degrees. The distance is 5 pixels, and the size is 0. Then click OK. For versions of Photoshop that don't have the plus signs next to the layer styles, make a copy of the face layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Double-click inner shadow of the copy to see it in the layer style window. Click the color box and pick white. Then click OK to close the color picker. Change the blend mode to linear dodge and make the opacity 15%. Global light is unchecked and make the angle 90 degrees. Make the distance 5 pixels and the size 0. Presently, we see the thin highlight along some of the edges of our image, but we don't see the thin shadows that we made earlier. To see the highlights and the shadows at the same time, drag the bottom face layer to the top of the Layers panel and change its blend mode to Lighten. Now we can see the highlights and the shadows. We'll convert the face layers into one smart object. Shift-click on the bottom face to make both layers active. Whether you have two separate layers, as you see here, or just one face layer that has two inner shadow layer styles, either way, the next step is the same. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel, and click Convert to Smart Object. To place the face into the pedestal document, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of the pedestal document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the image and release. To resize and reposition it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. Then press Enter or Return. Go to Filter, Blur, and Smart Blur. Make the radius 3, the threshold 25, and the quality low. Next, we'll add a shiny plastic-like texture. Go back to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Artistic folder and click Plastic Wrap. I'll make the highlight strength 7, the detail 1, and the smoothness 15. However, feel free to experiment with these amounts. Lastly, we'll cast its shadow onto the pedestal. Ctrl-click or Command-click the face to make a selection of its shape. Then Ctrl-click or Command-click the New Layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. In this empty layer, we'll fill the selection with black, and since black is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Deselect it and open your Transform tool. Go to the top middle anchor point and press and hold Ctrl or Command as you drag it down and to the right over the pedestal. Then press Enter or Return. Click the lock icon, which locks the transparent pixels. We can now affect the shadow while keeping the transparent pixels intact. Open your Gradient tool and make sure the Linear Gradient icon is active. Click the Gradient bar to open the Gradient Editor. Click the black-white thumbnail and click OK. Go to the bottom of the shadow and drag your Gradient tool to the right edge at the same angle as the shadow and release. Change its blend mode to Multiply. We'll remove the shadow on the curtain But first, we'll blur the shadow. Unlock the transparent pixels and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 1 pixel and click OK or press Enter or Return. Since shadows become softer the further away it is from its source, we'll do that as well. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag it over the top half of the shadow that's showing on the pedestal. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 50 pixels and click OK. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Drag the radius approximately 7 to 10 pixels and click OK. Then deselect it. Next, we'll remove the shadow on the curtain. Scroll to the bottom of the Layers panel and Ctrl-click or Command-click the thumbnail of the pedestal to make a selection of its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the shadow. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.